I'm so nervous. Oh, okay, wait. Hey guys, it's Sharon. Okay, so Justin dropped a new song, which means there's a new text prank coming for you. I was in Cuba, and Justin just dropped this song out of nowhere. Justin dropped a song with this group called Blood Pop, or this DJ. I'm assuming it's a DJ, it's very EDM. I don't know if it's a group or an individual, I'm sorry, I'm very uncultured on it. But anyways, their name is Blood Pop, and Justin dropped a song called Friends With Them, and I did not get to hear this song until like 2 or 3 days ago, when I got back from Cuba. So I'm in a different country, on an island, in the middle of the Caribbean, and Justin Bieber's over here dropping music. I feel very disrespected, but honestly, I'm really happy because it's a really good song. All Justin has been putting out lately is flat out bangers. I am here for this Justin. I am here for this era. I'm ready. Let's get it. But for now, we're doing a text prank. Now, there is a little background you need to know about this text prank, especially if you've seen my other text pranks. So if you see my other text pranks, you know majority of them are me texting like exes, texting my boyfriend, texting a crush. So I explained this in a Q&A video, but I still get comments about it, and I know this is probably gonna get more views in my Q&A, so I'll explain it again. The crush in the Despacito text prank is not the same person that is my boyfriend, or well, was my boyfriend. And this is gonna be that text prank. Surprise! Not necessarily my boyfriend anymore, which is why I haven't done a boyfriend tag or boyfriend Q&A, and which is why I've been avoiding those comments. So anyone that's asked for that video, I am so sorry. I'm not gonna say any names, although I do say his name in a video. So if you know his name, congrats. It's all good. I know he's subscribed to my channel as far as it goes. I don't know if he keeps up with my videos, but I'm just also gonna say I do have his permission to post this text prank flat out right off the bat. I'm saying that. Anyways, so he's still in my life. We're still friends. We still talk. We still catch up with each other. It's just not a relationship anymore. We both realized we weren't necessarily ready for that. So there's a little bit of wishy-washy between us, because you know, that's like, we were this and now we're that. So there's that behind it. And that's why when I heard Friends and I heard the lyrics, I was like, wow, this is literally what I went through with him, or what I kind of am still kind of in with him. So I figured he would be the best person to text these lyrics to. I don't think he's expecting a text prank because of what's gone on between us, but your girl's a savage. She does what she gotta do. So we're gonna do what we gotta do. I also just kind of wanna do this for my own selfish reasons, because the lyrics are really good and really relatable. So we're just gonna do it. Thank you, Justin. Always saving my life. So with that being said, now you guys know a little backstory to it, and now you know that there probably won't be a boyfriend tag anytime soon. Who knows, maybe in the future, I don't know. We're not gonna jinx anything. But if you guys do wanna see more text pranks, give this a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments below what you want to see next. And of course, subscribe for more so you're around to see it. I suggest you also follow me on my social media, including my Twitter and my Instagram, because I'm always asking you guys what videos you want to see next. And I'm always asking, what do I do? So you guys actually pick and choose my videos for me. Surprise. But anyways, enough of that. Let's get into this text prank and let's stir the pot a little bit. Thank you, Justin. Can we be friends? Let's get it. Okay, we're doing this again. These first lyrics make me a little bit nervous because they're about his mom. And it's not like his mom was looking for a job or looking for whatever. You know what? Whatever. I was wondering about your mama.
Did she get that job she wanted? What job? My mom wasn't looking for a job.
This is true. His mom has a stable job. Okay, he's probably gonna think I got him confused with someone else, or got the stories confused, because I do tend to do that a lot. So we're good. We're doing good. So that car that gave her problems,
I'm just curious about her honest. No, my mom's car is fine, lol, but she's been good, thanks.
This is almost like awkward. Like, there's some weird underlying, like, tension. I'm actually, like, nervous doing this. I think this is the first time I'm nervous doing a text prank. Oh my god, ew, feelings are gross. Ugh. Are you wondering why I've been calling?
Like, I got ulterior motives. What do you mean?
He said, W-D-Y-M. What do you mean? Another Bieber song? Literally, Justin apparently, like, is the sun to my world. I revolve around Justin Bieber. And that's so disgusting to say. I can't believe I said that. No, we didn't end this so good. But you know we had something so good.
I'm just not ready yet. We talked about this.
He had a dot dot. That's so awkward. Like, you know, you just feel the tension. Like, whenever someone adds dots, like, I do that all the time during the text rings. Like, it just makes things more serious and more like, well, dot dot dot. Oh my gosh, this is, oh God. I'm so nervous. Oh, okay. I'm wondering,
can we still be friends? Yes, LOL. We talked about that too.
Oh, we talked about that too. This is true. Like, this is generally a conversation we had about, like, still being friends. So this is almost like I'm trying to have that conversation again, even though we already had it. Too late to go back now. Doesn't have to end.
And if it ends, can we be friends? We are friends, LOL.
We're friends now. So now I can't make a text prank saying texting my boyfriend. It's just texting my friend who's a boy. Imagine I title out this video, no, I'm titling this texting my ex-boyfriend, because technically an ex now, which is, I hate my life. Also, for the most part, I do know I said this was my first relationship. That is true. And I do have other videos where I say I texted an ex. There's a difference between having a boyfriend and having a girlfriend and dating someone. So those other ex were people I dated, as in we just went on dates. But as like an official title of boyfriend and girlfriend, this was my first one. So thought I needed to clear the air for that, because everyone's like, how is this your first boyfriend when you've had ex-boyfriends? But there's also a difference between titling a video ex-boyfriend and ex-guy I dated, you know? But anyways, let's continue. This next line, he's not gonna lie to me because he's always been blunt and honest and he's always given it to me straight. So I trust him. I know he won't lie to me, which is what makes me nervous, because this next line is basically me asking if there's someone else that's gotten into the picture. And I don't think I necessarily am ready for the answer. I know I need to hear the answer. Oh my God. Okay, let's just do it. Wondering if you got a body
to hold you tight since I left. No, I don't. What about you?
Oh, thank God. You don't understand. Like, I feel like 3 tons just got lifted off my shoulder. This, honestly, you know what? I don't care if he does end up watching this video, which he probably will, because he knows it's gonna end up being a text ring upload. Sup, boo. What it do? Guys, if you haven't noticed, I'm as open and honest and blunt as it gets. It is what it is. I don't care much. I have no shame. Whatever. Next. My God, this line is a little bit nerve-wracking too. Like, I want to believe he thinks about me as much as I think about him. Like, I'll think about him every now and then, and I want to believe it's the same. Like, you know that saying, when you're thinking about someone, they're thinking about you too? So I like to think that's real, because sometimes I'll be thinking about someone and then all of a sudden they like hit me up and it's been like forever, you know? So I do kind of want to believe in that I hate that word. And I kind of do believe in it. So that being said, this question or this next lyric line makes me a little bit nervous, because if I'm wrong, I'm gonna be butthurt. Thank you, Justin. You really out here making people grow balls and do stuff. Hashtag grow balls. That's gonna be the comment for today. Hashtag grow balls. Life lesson. Wondering if you think about me.
Actually, don't answer that. LOL. Too bad. I do sometimes.
Oh my God, he said too bad, and I thought he was talking about like him not thinking about me, like too bad I don't think about you, but no, he said I do sometimes, so that's enough for me. Hey, at least he said something and didn't ignore it. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Honestly, this song is just gonna continue to repeat, which is why I feel like this text prank might be a bit shorter, because this is an EDM song, so all it does is repeat the same lines over and over again, so it's not like I can get back into like a hook or a chorus right now, so I'm just gonna end it with the line, can we be friends? Justin, you're giving me a repetitive script. What can I do? Let's see. And the grand finale. Can we be friends?
Sharon, what the f***? LOL, keep asking and we won't be. LOL.
Okay, honestly, this is a fair response. He said, keep asking and we won't be. I don't blame him. I asked like 3 or 4 times. But that technically wasn't my fault. It was technically someone else's fault. And you and I both know who. Anyways, wow. I mean, like, you know how you have your own, like, intuition about things? I feel like that's how I am with this situation. I kind of knew or kind of expected how it was gonna go because I know him and I know, like, who he is as a person. I know me and I know who I am as a person. I know how we work. So I feel like this kind of just reassured my own thoughts, which is actually really helpful because, guys, relationships are work. They're not always rainbows and butterflies. Oh, what's that saying by Maroon 5? It's not always rainbows and butterflies, it's lies and compromise. Something like that. Another life lesson. Thank you, Maroon 5. Anyways, I forgot what I was saying. This is what happens when I go on a trail of lyrics from other musicians. I feel satisfied after this prank, or this text prank. Yeah, this was a prank, technically. Yeah, any text prank is a prank. What am I saying? I just feel like this was more a personal conversation to me, only because I think the lyrics were so relatable, which is probably why I don't see it that much as a prank. But I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys stop requesting boyfriend tag videos now, because it's kind of awkward. But it is what it is. If you guys enjoyed this, give us a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments below what text prank you want to see next. And of course, subscribe for more. Hello. You can't see them if you're not around to see them. But anyways, with all that being said, I will see you guys next time. Bye.